So finally, I would like to welcome Mr. Yemuru Chanel, the CEO for Moneta Technologies, to deliver his speech. Mr. Yemuru, welcome.
Celebrate today that for the first time the consumer or the individual is the winner. The reason that I'm saying this is because remittance has been a major tool of dominance in the Western world with those who are in the third world. So, you know, when you look at the companies like Western Union, MoneyGram and so forth, these companies have created dominance in terms of forex transfers around the world. They control the money transfers around the world. It's not just in Ethiopia, it's around the world. So they dominate everything. So what this opportunity that we have created with Flutterwave, the reason that we have made a big deal in terms of announcing it, it's because the consumer on the other end has 100% control where he is sending the money. And the money can go directly, as Atmos for said, into a wallet, into a bank account, or it can be a cash pickup. So what that gives us is basically total control in terms of how we transfer money, forex, around the world. And technologies like Flutterwave barter app, which allows you to do is basically send whatever you have in your bank account, cash, credit card, whatever the case might be, into another wallet, which is Amole in this case. So the winner is the consumer, and the winner by the consumer winning is Ethiopia is also a winner in this case. And when Ethiopia today is Western Union or MoneyGram, the money comes in and it sits in the cloud until all the banks look for ways to attract the consumer that is here in Ethiopia to catch the consumer to come and cash it. And that money, all the banks in Ethiopia, if you are aware, except Dashen, every one of them advertise they're going to give you cars, they're going to give you this, they're going to give you tablets, they're going to give you phones and so forth, just so that you can come and cash that money from. So who's in control? The one that is in control is the money remittance companies. We need the forex as a country, they know that, because this is a consumer market with the import and export imbalance. We need the forex. Without the forex, we don't exist as a country. They know that better. So when you send money from anywhere in the world to Ethiopia today, it costs you, the consumer pays on the other end, anywhere in 10% of the total remittance. 10% is a significant amount of money. If I send $1,000, that's $100 that you would be paying in fees. Today in Ethiopia, the distribution channel for money is limited. So they have the ability to charge that much. And since we need the forex, we are just willing to take anything. Not anymore. With Amole and Flutterwave, the capability that we have built, anyone can integrate on our platform and we can deliver that money into the wallet, into the bank account, and to be able to cash out. It's a big win for the consumer. And you know, today we put the title of this announcement, Remittance for Financial Inclusion and E-commerce. The reason is that remittance, there is a lot of use cases and case studies that has been published, that remittance is one of the ways that you can actually increase and promote financial inclusion. As part of that, you know, Ethiopia has a huge diaspora community. You know, different statistics are out there, but anywhere in the 8 million range of diaspora is outside of Ethiopia. Those 8 million diaspora, today, through the formal channel, there is about $5.4 billion coming into the country. This $5.4 billion is just a drop in the bucket, because the actual amount coming into the market, into the Ethiopian market, is a lot more than that. Because a lot of the money stays in the country of origin. But what comes into Ethiopia is someone here is giving money in birr, and they are taking the dollar over there. So no forex is coming. So this is the traditional hawala business. So the hawala business is keeping the country from growing, because we don't have that forex coming in, but the actual money is being transacted. So this informal market is huge. This informal market hurts everyone overall, because inflation, the expense, the high living expense that we pay here, is because shortage of forex. So when you look at all this, it makes sense that when we are doing remittance, first of all, we are helping our brothers and loved ones and so forth, bringing in forex into the country. If they are not in the in the formal banking financial system, now they can be in the financial system, because the remittance is coming into a wallet, into bank account, and so forth. So we are banking them as the forex is coming into the country. So financial inclusion is part of this solution. The other one is e-commerce. The reason that we say e-commerce, because now that we have the ability from a mobile app or an application to be able to send money, we can also do remit to pay. What remit to pay does is basically is that now Flutterwave's barter app can actually consume any of the services that we have on our platform for the diaspora to pay for school fees, to pay their mortgages, to pay their medical bills, to pay anything per se that is available on Amole. So what that does is basically the consumer again is in control on where that money is being spent. I'm sure that if I ask the question, everyone will tell me here that how many of your loved ones that is in diaspora has been sending money for different purposes, and that money is not being used for that purpose. It gets lost because we have other needs and whatever the case might be. And if it is going into a savings account, when that diaspora comes into their country, that money is spent, is gone. But if I have 100% control in terms of where the money is going, including my own bank account here from from abroad, I am in control as a consumer. I am in charge. And that gives the empowerment to the consumer on the other side. So the e-commerce component is that now we can pay for services, for products, and all those different things from abroad to our loved ones right here, where the person is in 100% control in terms of where that money is being spent. So this initiative is a lot bigger than just remitting money across the border. We are talking about financial inclusion. We are talking about e-commerce. We are talking about empowering the consumer in terms of where the money is going. And we are also empowering on both ends of the equation. So it's a big win
And today we celebrate that the consumer is for the first time a winner. Thank you.